people at other tables are very curious about it and watching you pass it around. So you do have to be very careful about making sure that you get it back, which again, that's why we have the armed guards outside today. So where was this located? Basically, we've had it in our circulation department here at the Lake Worth campus. We also have it located at the other campuses, and we'll get to that in just a minute. We started out with checking out it as a three-hour reserve. We're discovering that's really not the most popular or best way to do it. You need to check it out a little bit longer than that. That's not a model. That's not a bad model, maybe for some classes that work that way, but for the most part, that we wouldn't recommend that. We have it in our reading lab right now here at the college. We've used it with honors classes, and we have it at the other campus LORCs. In regard to who participated in it, we've had an ENC 1121 honors course use this. 14 students use it in that class with 15 readers, one for the teacher. And we did three cups of tea. We did this last year. We did our Read Together project as three cups of tea before we knew the author was going to be coming. It just happened to be a nice coincidence that we were able to tag into that. We sent a table of people that we did with a raffle to the luncheon to get to talk or hear Greg Mortensen's talk. We also had an audiobook version of Three Cups of Tea on it and the Kindle user guide, and the honors class used that for the entire term. We've also used this in our strategies for college success courses, a couple of them. 27 students per class. In this case, we were checking them out 3 hours at a time. We used it for three cups of tea in one class and Eat That Frog in another class. In particular, we put a lot of materials on reserve all the time for different classes, and the reserve model for this does save a great deal of room. I'll show you in a second just how much that is sometimes. We check out the Kindle reader to the learning specialist in the reading lab for one semester to use. The reading labs here at the college, they have a number of different books that they use with students as they come in. And they've recommended reading lists and things of that nature. And we're loading those books onto those readers so that they can use them there and not have to take up quite as much space. The general reserve room you already mentioned. In addition to that, you can do things like the New York Times bestsellers, as they mentioned there before, for $9.99. Wall Street Journal bestsellers in general. Textbooks, we're going to get to them in just a minute. In terms of intro library loan, we've loaned this out to the Bellway campus and four Kindle readers at the Palm Beach Gardens, newly renovated, beautiful LORC in Palm Beach Gardens campus. The general guidelines for each group were we've got wide open access to all the functions. You order from the Kindle store directly, posting observations, suggestions, and comments to our blog to take as much input as we can with everybody. We've looked at this as sort of an exploration of, will you tell us how you'd like to use this? We've tried to encourage everybody to use it, and every time I run into somebody about it, when they ask me about it, they say, I heard you can check these out. And I usually say, yeah, just send me an email and with a book title that you'd like us to order. We'll order it for you, and then just come on over and check it out, and you can see what you think of it. And most everyone praises it and thinks very highly of it. But there's been an interesting variety of responses, and these are some of them. For instance, it helped frame the page to lessen distractions. The second language student said, I'm enjoying the Kindle more than I expected to. The screen is easy to read, and I like I can change the font. They mentioned that before, especially if you're 55 years old or you've always worn glasses your whole life. You can change the font size on this, and no one has to know that. The Kindle, I didn't get sleepy as I do with reading books. It might work as a mnemonics tool. It's one of the observations. In some of our classes here, when I hold it, my mind tells me gaming, and when I read, I want a book. This was sort of an interesting conversation. You know, a lot of the literature, if you go out and look at it, the Kindles are actually much more accepted right now from sort of a middle-aged time period. Now, middle-aged, of course, is 15 years older than whatever you are. very accepted device because, at least partially, one of the theories is, it models a book. And one of the little discussions we got into with one of the classes, what we did with each one of these projects is we pulled them into the library to discuss what they thought of it after they finished using it. And one day we had this little discussion, and one of the students said, well, for me, when I hold a device like this, I'm thinking gaming. When I read a book, I want a book. And we thought, well, now that's interesting. And they'd gone out of their way, you know, to mimic the experience of reading a book. For some students, the experience of reading a book is so foreign. They're not picking up on that. They're picking up on the gaming aspect of a device like that, which we thought, well, I'm not sure I expected that, but it was sort of an interesting observation. Some of the surveys we've done, 66% and higher have said that they liked using it overall. In general, the overwhelming response has been very positive. How do we access it? Right now, we're accessing it with a barcode and a barcode number on the inside of the covers of the boxes. We're in the process of cataloging these directly into our library catalog. That's a tricky bit of business, and we're still trying to sort that out exactly. How is this going to work? How are we going to catalog the actual devices themselves, probably too, and the books that we can put on there? But it's a little bit of a sticky wicket to try to figure out how to do that, because you can move the titles around to the individual devices. And you can do that remotely, so you don't even have to have them in your hand. As you buy the titles, they all store remotely. In addition to storing on the device itself, they store remotely with Amazon. And you have up to 6 copies of each one of those ones that are in storage that you can put on a device at any one time. And you can, you know, sort of pick and choose which ones that you want to put on the devices. So it's a little bit of a tricky bit of business right now to figure out how we